So units like nanoseconds are fairly hard to understand. So what I want to do to give a better understanding of what the different types of memory in a computer are is turn those into different units and compare them. So if we think about the light bulb switch, which certainly would not be a reasonable way to store memory in a computer today, the cost per bit is probably about 50 cents. So we can buy light bulbs for about 50 cents. Let's assume the sensing is free. It's already going to be ridiculously expensive. So we'll call it US dollars 50 cents per bit for using a light bulb and a light sensor. The latency is about 1 second. And what we're going to do in the quiz is convert latencies in terms of time, in terms of the equivalent for the distance light travels in that amount of time. The other type of memory I mentioned, and we didn't see this because it's sort of hard to extract from the computer, is the CPU register. And the registers are part of the processor, so it's hard to measure their actual cost. It's probably close to a tenth of a cent, though, if we look at the total cost of the processor and how that depends on the number of registers you have. The amount of memory that you have in registers is close to a kilobyte or two in a typical processor. Only a few thousand bytes in the registers. The latency is the shortest of any of these. It's less than a nanosecond. And the time to get memory from a register has to be short enough that you can do it within a single cycle. So we saw our cycle speed for the processor was 2.7 gigahertz. That means we need to do 2.7 billion cycles in a second. The time of a cycle is less than 0.4 nanoseconds. Within a given cycle, we at least need to be able to get memory out of a register. So that's an approximation of the time there. So we'll measure the latency distance in terms of meters for light. So the third type of memory we've talked about so far is the DRAM. The cost per bit for the DRAM, well, our DRAM costs about $10 and it stores 2 gigabytes. So in order to write down the cost per bit, we really need a new unit. If we try to write it in terms of dollars and cents, it's going to be far too hard to see. So to fit DRAM into this, well, DRAM, it cost 10 US dollars for 2 gigabytes. If we want to write that in terms of a meaningful cost per bit, we need a new kind of currency. We're going to need far too many zeros before we get to the value using regular dollars and cents. So we're going to use a new kind of currency. So to measure the cost of DRAM in a meaningful way, we need a new kind of currency, which we'll call a nano dollar. A nano dollar is 1/1,000,000,000th of a dollar. So if we have a billion nano dollars, that would make $1. And I don't have one of these on paper. It's money that's really not worth the paper that it's printed on, but it's a useful unit for measuring the cost per bit. So now we have a more useful currency for measuring the cost per bit of DRAM. And the cost of DRAM turns out to be, in terms of nanodollars, 0.58 nanodollars per bit. And we saw that the latency for DRAM was 12 nanoseconds. So now for the quiz, I want you to figure out the latency distance for each of these different types of memory. Note that the units are different here. We use dollars and nanodollars. For the distances, we're going to use kilometers, meters, and meters. And you've got all the information you have here. As a reminder, the speed of light is about 300,000 kilometers per second.